Let's go to the did you know what a wet market is and why does it matter? This is gross. I'm sorry, but we need to know about it. A wet market in China, and I've seen the videos, and I'm telling you, don't look at the videos unless you've got a strong stomach. They take dogs and cats and other animals that are alive, and they slaughter them right in front of you while they're alive. They cut them up, and they put them in bags, and they hand them to the customers as food, because those are considered delicacies.
And Barry, and so, by the way, I have been in those wet markets. I've seen the wet markets. I've been all over Asia. They do that, and there's not a lot of sanitary things that are happening there. There's not a lot of cleanup. There's no refrigeration. It's pretty nasty, actually. Very nasty.
And the really weird part is sane people say, this is gross. This is inhumane. There has to be a better way. And yet, the World Health Organization has announced in the last couple of days that they consider these things fine, even though A, it's inhumane and gross, and B, these animals literally are covered in feces, their own blood, the blood and feces of other animals. There are no sanitary conditions. It's a wonder. It's a literal medical wonder, Kent, that everybody that doesn't go through a wet market doesn't come out of there with half a dozen diseases, not the least of which is this COVID-19 flu.
Or come out the other end with an amazing immune system. Now, what I find most interesting about this particular story is the fact that you'd mentioned to me before, they're talking about this thing started with a bat. How could that happen if?
Yeah, here's the killer. You've heard the bat story. Everybody's seen the pictures all over social media of these Chinese people eating bat soup. Literally, it's a bat in a bowl, and somehow they make soup with it, and you eat it. And then they eat the bat. Supposedly, COVID-19 jumped from bats to humans because somebody bought a contaminated bat. In other words, the bat had the infection at this wet market in Wuhan. Investigations are now coming out that the wet market that was identified by the Chinese government as the source of the COVID-19 worldwide pandemic in Wuhan, China, that supposedly came from bat soup, is a market that doesn't sell bats, Kent.
They don't sell bats. So the market that supposedly all this started in with a bat has never sold bats. Go figure.
That's the story.
Go figure.
Yeah, well, the story's collapsing under the weight of the lie, apparently, and it doesn't make any sense, and they got caught.
It's unbelievable.
That's the reality is, Wuhan, China, where the virus originated, which nobody literally of any sane point of view argues with, is also the home of the Wuhan Bioweapons Laboratory, where they make viruses that could infect the entire world and kill the world's population. They have that laboratory in the same place. And they, the Wuhan Bioweapons Laboratory, have been working with the coronavirus weaponization program for over a decade. Now, that is a stated fact, and that is a known fact. And I'm more of the opinion it came out of that laboratory and got out somehow, i.e. a worker got infected his family, and then it just exploded, versus the bat story that, well, doesn't hold soup.
So true. By the way, I heard a theory yesterday. Actually, it came out of, I think somebody in the government put it out, that that lab was actually developing these different viruses, and this particular one was being developed so that they could prove to the United States that they could respond quicker than the United States could. Don't know if there's any truth to that or not. It was in AP where I read that yesterday.
I saw the same story, Kent, and maybe that's true, but let's get the facts out and let's get it to the public. This is not a bat mistake. This is a virus that leaked from a weapons laboratory, the end. And let's start telling the truth. I mean, I think it's important. We deserve it, don't we?
I think absolutely. And again, the fact that it's going to be, you know, the numbers are going to play out that this is way less dangerous ever than the regular flu or probably a common cold. That's where the rubber meets the road here. That's where the big hoax has been.
Yeah, if we can add one talking point to what you just said, when you factor in the following, and I think people really need to hear this. If you're under 60 and in reasonably good health, meaning you don't have heart disease, you haven't had a lung transplant, you don't have emphysema, you don't have cancer, you don't have leukemia, and on and on and on, your chances of dying from COVID-19 are not 0.0001. It's you add zeros. It's almost microscopic. We have 330 plus million Americans, and the death rate is in the 20,000s. It's almost infinitesimal. More people die in a normal week of automobile accidents. But if you take out the already sick, the already immunocompromised, it drops by a factor of another 10. So this is almost unrecognizable as a cause of death. And there's one other thing that bothers me. In many cases, hospital officials, either in morgues or in hospitals, are being told if someone has COVID-19 and dies, the cause of death is COVID-19. Now, on the surface, that sounds logical, except if they already have heart disease or emphysema, they're 85 years old, they already have cancer, they would have died in not too long anyway. They have no immune function, right? The COVID-19 pushed them a little bit and over the edge. But for normal, healthy people, very, 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 very few are dying.